St. Patrick's Church. So pretty. We're on our way to Ford's Theater. And here we are, Ford's Theater. And the house right over there. There he is where he died, across the street. Peterson House.
To Washington immediately, but he asked, what would the nation think of his president stealing into its capital like a thief at night? When the advisors convinced Lincoln that the rumors were not true, he agreed to secretly board a sleeping car disguised.
Struggling to maintain the government or to overthrow it. I am struggling especially to prevent others from overthrowing it.
April 14, 1861. Fort Sumter, pounded by Confederate batteries, surrenders. Lincoln's response is immediate. The next day, he called for 75,000 volunteers for military service. A newfound unity of purpose swept across the North. Recruitment stations were flooded with men eager to put down the rebellion. But things were different in the North. The president had no constitutional right to deprive citizens of their civil liberties.
I am an old man, very old man, but perhaps I was preserved for this occasion.
But Lincoln chose to temporarily suspend this one liberty to save the Union.
Excuse me. Conspirators. O'Loughlin, Samuel Arnold, and David Harold Lewis Powell. She owned the boarding house less than a mile from the White House.
This is the gun that Booth would use to kill Abraham Lincoln. Just below it, you can see a reproduction of the round lead ball used to commit the crime. A .44 caliber single-shot muzzle-loaded derringer. It was made to be easily hidden in a pocket and was used more by criminals than soldiers at the time. Booth most likely chose it because it was so easy to conceal. By using it as the murder weapon, he committed himself to having just one shot.
Eerie dream he had. Did you know he dreamed about it?
Mm-hmm. He did. I read that in some book one time. So on this side it shows what Lincoln did that day, and this side it shows what Booth did that day. Hear that clock ticking? Y'all tired? We've been going at it all day. Guess you just go in that door.
Well, say, Chris.
Just come right on in. You're good with the tickets.
Okay.
Let me know if there are any questions at all.
She waited in this parlor.
With friends.
They pretty much just come in here and took over his house. You know? Yeah.
What was this place anyways?
It was a boarding house.
Is that it? How could he fit on that little bed?
In this room, President Rinkin died at 7:22 a.m. So he lived until the next morning.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Washington all the way down into
paralyzed from the neck down.
Let me have a moment.
We know you're in there. Come out.
If you'll take your men 50 yards from the door, I'll come out and fight you. Give me a chance for my life.
We did not come here to fight you. We came to make you a prisoner.
Well, my brave boys, prepare a stretcher for me.
Fire the barn.
Yes, the quicker the better. Who? He's shot. We got him.
Carry him out before the barn burns.
Mother, I died for my country.
These are all of the books that's been written about Lincoln. Yeah. That's a lot of books written about Lincoln.